Next, we have Greg. Greg is an independent researcher in water resources management and a coordinator of the Pune chapter of Datameet.
So I'm taking Tej's place because Tej is not well today. So Datameet is basically a community of people that work on data issues across India. So we have 5 chapters in different cities. It started in Bangalore, but there are chapters in Ahmedabad, Delhi, Pune, Mumbai. I'm part of the Pune chapter of Datameet. So what I'm going to talk about briefly is it starts with the problem that in India, the government doesn't share raw spatial data. They don't share shapefiles, they don't share GeoJSON boundaries of any administrative boundaries, areas of interest that you would need. So in the DME group, a lot of the discussions have generally been surrounding, okay, where do we get these sort of shapefiles, these sort of boundaries that for creating almost any map that you need, to depict various issues, you need these boundaries to start with. Can I get a quick poll of how many of you guys are new to JS? How many of you are like, okay, what's the shapefile, what's the GeoJSON? Okay, so some. So most of you are familiar. But this is more, so this is an effort that Datameet has sort of been trying to put together, wherein to answer the many questions that keep coming up about where do I find these maps that I need. So this website is put together, has assembly constituencies, parliamentary constituencies, state district boundaries, some municipalities, and some state village boundaries of some states. So you can go to it later, the link is available here. So you see district boundaries, for instance, each of the files have been formatted to a particular, to contain certain attribute information. So state district name, district code, etc. You can take a quick view of the shapefile, the GeoJSON files in your browser itself. So there's parliamentary constituency maps. For example, so you can see, for example, where these maps are used, the kind of analysis and visualizations you can do with it. There's village boundaries too. So this may take a little while to load, but it generally has a lot of the basic attributes that you would need. So village code 2011-2001, and you can take a, and they all share under open licenses. So that's there. Here are some tools that people that starting to learn GIS, starting to work with maps, can use to quickly and easily understand or work with these formats. If any of you are not part of the Datameet group, you're not aware of it, or you're not aware of any discussions there, this is the Google group that you can go. Most people starting out with data inevitably find themselves coming here and going like, okay, someone pointing them to Datameet and saying, okay, so where go there, you may be able to find the data that you need. So a lot of related discussions. If you're looking for the discussions about where do these community-created maps originate, there are discussion threads within the Google group about who's put the maps together. If you have any questions about the maps themselves, you can throw it out onto the group. So that's it.